I'm going to set this workshop up. The Twin Creek String Band is here in Floyd and Franklin County and all around this part of the world. One of our favorite string bands, and I know you've heard a little bit, and if you haven't, you'll understand why. They come from a long history of playing this music around Southwest Virginia, and mostly playing for dancers. That's why they play this music. Prior to the Twin Creek String Band, it was most of these fellows are coming from the Dry Hill Draggers, which is a really incredible dance band that was playing around Southwest Virginia for the last 30, 40 years. And so what we're going to do today, there will be an opportunity in the second half of the workshop to maybe bust out your instrument and play along. I thought we thought it would be cool to sort of dissect the way they play string band music around here and give you all an opportunity to ask questions. And we're going to have Caleb and Reeb from the Foghorn String Band in here also to sort of moderate and ask some questions as folks who live on the other side of the country and how they fell in love with this music from all the way across the other side of the United States. And they are huge fans of the music from around here. So they're going to come in and ask a few questions. But I think what we'll do first is let these gentlemen play a tune for you. Over here on the banjo, this is Jared Boyd. And then back on the bass is his dad, Stacy Boyd. And Chris Prilliman on the fiddle. And Jason Hambert on the guitar. And they're going to just play a fiddle tune for you.
Thank you. I'm not asking questions. I'm Caleb Potter, but I'm Foghorn Stringband. Off the front. I'm sure everyone has some questions, but I'll fire a couple away. I'm just kind of curious. Y'all are playing, and who raise your hand if you're playing melody. Who's playing melody up there? Who's playing rhythm?
Trying.
Cool. I mean, that's pretty obvious, I think, but I also am hearing like lots of melody kind of in all of it. So it's like, that's why I was wondering, like, definitely banjo and fiddle both playing melody, but also playing rhythm kind of obvious, right? That banjo, they got tons of rhythm going. What's that last tune? I didn't really know that one.
That's Sweet Bunch of Days, the rocker version of it. Yeah. Of course, that's an old
little song.
Well,
he dated one. It was a slow song, but he dated it.
I think it's Kenny Baker.
He dated it, started playing Wild Oats.
Yeah.
That's an interesting
song. Probably took some of the notes out of it. Dance to it.
Yeah. Cool. Awesome. I'm curious why you're playing a resident banjo. Calling that's like obviously not common. We had that going in our band as well too for a while. I'm curious why you're chosen. What's going on with that?
Right. Well, that's the traditional thing to do in our band in the Roddy Fires that came before. My grandfather would play in that band, and my uncle would play with these guys for years. Played a resonator banjo, and it's has a different sound to it, but it's also louder.
Yeah.
Recognize
your friends.
Can you work it? Can you do it on like Jimmy Cole's move? I'm trying to keep some of the shooting version.
Anybody else have a question they want to ask?
I'll ask another one.
Yeah.
When you guys play dances, I'm sure you have some of them slower tunes. And do you think of those waltzes? I hear bands around here say, we'll play a two-step, and sometimes I can't tell if that's a 3-4 time waltz or if that's just a slower 4-4 tune.
Well, most of the time it was called a slow tune, and it just depends on the tune, whether it's a 3-4 time waltz or actual two-step 4-4 time tune. And that's one thing about us is that when we play a slow tune, and I think a lot of the bands around here, old time bands around here, when they play a slow tune, it's not slow. I mean, it's still got kind of a pithy.
You do play? What are you talking about, Chris?
Yeah.
Play us something else.
Two-step or a waltz?
We're going to find
two
out.
Two-step or a waltz?
It's a sunshine.
Convention, it was 1986, I believe, it was, sure.
Bill Brown's come out and play Sal Ann, Brian Greger's come out and play Sal Ann, Mike Brown's come out and play Sal Ann. Throw a mix in is what I like to do, but somebody else is not doing.
Yeah, cool. Which is my other question, like, how much stuff do you guys bring into the repertoire that no one else is doing? I mean, obviously that song, that's great. I never heard an old time band play that song. But why not? It's perfect. You know? You bring a lot in that way?
I think several enough. I think 50%.
If it fits and works?
Yeah. Yeah, probably 50% of my vocals is from probably the early years of bluegrass.
Yeah.
We do an old time to something for the dancers.
Yeah.
And I just want to comment on that from the perspective of the Floyd Country Store, where the dancers rule. You know, a band like the Twin Creek String Band and a lot of bands have started playing early bluegrass. And when I look at videos from the early 90s in a full dance floor, they were playing bluegrass tunes as much as they were playing old time tunes. But the early bluegrass material is danceable.
It's a lot of Brownstown, Country Gentlemen, something that Millie Earnhardt, Rainbird, home. What fits the dancers? That's what catered to dancers.
I love that you say that, because that's just what it's all about, right? It's like,
it's to us.
Yeah.
And 99% of the shows we go out to do, let's get the face of Dylan, because we do a point they stole his dances. Every now and then we get thrown into a little concert somewhere, we like a fish out of water, and then
I got another question for you. I'm here teaching a mandolin class. I play mandolin in Foghorn String Band. And we did have a banjo for a long time. He's not playing with us anymore, so kind of don't have a banjo. So I've sort of fallen into a banjo rhythm role in a way, kind of because I know that hole is missing. But I'm just curious. I'm actually really aware of my part when I do play the banjo player. I'm aware that I've kind of gotten into that spot in rhythm. How do you guys feel about mandolin? Because that came up in our class today, like mandolin and in the full-time band.
Well, in this band, there's never been a mandolin player. I know the band that Eddie Bond plays in, the band I was in, Klauder, they have a mandolin player, always have, and it fills in for the guitar strum, sort of chop, because their guitar player mandolin plays runs and doesn't do much for the strum, so that's where their mandolin player comes in. And there have been mandolin players over the years. I know Merlin Clifton was the mandolin player for just about all the Surrey County, all the good Surrey County old-time bands back in the day. And we never had one. But that, you know, to your point, you're filling for the banjo space in the sound, in the overall sound. As much as I don't like the fact that y'all don't have a banjo player, I still love your sound. It's still old time, absolutely.
Yeah.
It is nothing else. It's old time. When you play those tunes, it sounds like there's nothing missing. And I hate it.
Listen hard to our banjo player. Obviously, obviously I want to hear the melody, and I started playing melody stuff, but it's that banjo rhythm that really, you know, fitting over that bass and guitar that really gives that track foundation for the fiddle, you know?
Yeah.
I think we all want to hear more. I mean, anybody else have questions? I'm sure there's probably
I mean, maybe a little late, but you talked about creating or, you know, having a hard driving sound. So what do you do? What decisions are you making when you decide to play a tune to create a hard driving sound? As just by yourself or with a group? You know, I don't know, maybe if you're playing the tune and it's not there, so what do you have to fix to create that?
Well, for me, the answer is easy. More strumming, like pull the air down on it and on the strums, and I don't do as much individual note picking, like I'll pick on more energy into it.
Like dropping notes then would be one.
Yeah, leaving some notes out. It's there's always some trade-off to it. Want good hard driving rhythm, you gotta take some notes out. Not all of the time, but like I say, he's not playing around anymore. But Ray Chatfield could play driving music, driving Klauder or banjo, and get every single note in. Sometimes I strike the lead a little bit like that. But at the same time, also, Chris is leaving a decent number of melody notes out sometimes.
That don't hurt my foot.
He'd be the first to tell you, and he definitely don't add any extra.
I'll tell you what, if you was asking about where you get it, you can say, hello. It's just like it, you know. I mean, it's all in how you go about something. You can be monotone and just do this, hey, you know.
Simple and straight, and it's hard driving. There's nothing else. And I remember asking him for lessons, and he was like, I can't show you anything. And I'm like, yes, you can. How do you do that? Just so solid. And I think a lot of the drive is coming, and then Jason, his runs and how he fits in there. I think it's just giving Jared and Chris everything they need to sit on top. It's the right combination.
A few weeks ago, we played without Jason. So
yeah, it's kind of a testament to this, like, your overall timing and rhythm feel that you all kind of have together. Because, you know, like, you're playing simple stuff on the bass as far as the note choices. You're not doing lots of runs. But you just... yeah, but it's where you're putting it. You know, it's like, it's that feel, that timing, and that thing is something that's so hard to talk about or teach. Like, you have to just feel it. You have to want it, you know.
I think he's trying to teach people about it.
Well, more music, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll call it. Anybody want to set in for set in and play with the small one this last one or two? And then back to the thing we'll have. We'll be right back.
Where do you come from? Where do you go away?